world of air travel, now at everybody's doorstep, has been created in 50 years or less. A world of flashing propellers, shimmering jet streams, gleaming shapes. Oh, sighting, that it's sometimes hard to get it in focus. Around the globe, passengers are now leaving on regular scheduled flights at a rate of more than 70 million a year. Some are already old hands in the air, but for many there's still the thrill of novelty. A bustle of preparations all around, and behind the scenes too, there are operations. Northern Canada via Montreal. Excess baggage? It's those last minute presents for the kids. Passenger Kofi Agine of West Africa for another. Going from Accra up country to Tamale on urgent business. And here in Bombay, Sita Desai, with an overnight flight ahead and young Mira in her arms. Won't be long now, they're loading the baggage. Each passenger gets a free allowance of baggage. On a long-distance flight, it adds up to about 2 tons in the hold. Then there's the mail, mountains of it. These days, the air carries the equivalent of 15 million letters around the world every week.
Gentlemen, flight 906. To
Juan Perez, Caracas, Venezuela, with some routine things to see to in Maturin, briefcase bulging, and a lot to do en route. Minoru Yamata, aged 18, from Tokyo to California, USA, his first venture into the big world alone. And from Burlington, Vermont, Dorothy Gerstein and Irene Cooper, school teachers, with 3 weeks to see the Middle East and bring it home. Who travels? Everybody. It used to be for the first class few. But now, with tourist fares, the air's for all. For the world, his wife and child. And sometimes even his goose. Goodbye, good trip, and happy landings.
This is the captain speaking to you from the flight deck. We're about to take off now. Fasten your lap straps, please. And no smoking till we're airborne. Thank you.
Herself. What of her? She'll probably be a Douglas, a Boeing, or a Lockheed Constellation, a Convair or a Vickers Viscount. She'll weigh as much as 60 tons and carry a crew of up to 10. She'll travel at 300 miles an hour or more and fly at any height from 5 to 30,000 feet.
Cross Epsom 2000, 783,000. Reply on the radar, obtaining 15,000 feet.
Runway 17, the wind south southwest 5.
Hotel Foxtrot, your traffic is diesel now on final and DC-3 living pattern outbound heading for 180 degrees, over.
Weber 100, you're cleared to taxi to runway 25 left. I taxi away Charlie and runway 13 left.
They taxi out from the aprons to the runways. Slowly turn and stop for the final check.
Before takeoff check,
please. Auto feathering.
Moving right on.
Alternators.
Race it on. Body's normal.
Feather pitch.
Fully fine. Order rich lock on.
Fuel valve.
Check tank to engine. Booster power.
On all.
Generator.
All on.
Ignition switches.
Check down by
1,000 trim tabs.
Controls are free.
Engine ready to take off.
Ready for takeoff.
Ready for takeoff, sir.
Stand by to takeoff.
Honor.
in the heart of Ethiopia, where drifting spume and flashing rainbow guard the birthplace of the Blue Nile. Or you may look down into the tremendous mouth of Popocatepetl, towering 18,000 feet above the sea, crater within crater. Be some testament to bygone human splendor, like Machu Picchu, city of the Incas, lifting its blind walls from the gorges of the Andes to the mansions of the sun. Or yet again, your path across the sky may lead you through the very summits of the world. Of the scientists and the daring of the pioneers, it's been the patience of the organizers. Patience and collaboration. This is a body of which little is heard. IATA, the International Air Transport Association. Its present Director General is Sir William Hildred of Great Britain. IATA's members are the international airlines, about 75 of them all told. They inherited a world of regulations made for caravans and wagon trains and sailing ships. Progressively, they freed the sky from this archaic outlook, hammered out a common order, common codes and standards. Argument, competition, cut and thrust. But out of it all, the air has emerged as an outstanding instance of international good sense. Look beyond the conference room at how it works in practice.